In this graph, we want to look at myogenic autoregulation. In other words, how microvessels respond to changes in the perfusion pressure to maintain normal flow to a particular tissue. And what we're going to do is we're going to graph blood flow through a vessel relative to the perfusion pressure driving flow through that vessel. And we can see that's laid out here in Poisson's law. In Poisson's law, we can see that the driving pressure, delta P, is directly proportional to the flow through that vessel. Now, this is not the only factor affecting and regulating blood flow through a particular tissue. We certainly want to also match blood flow to metabolic need, but this is going to be overlaid with this myogenic effect. And what we find at A is at a normal perfusion pressure, we will generate a normal or autoregulated amount of blood flow that is meeting metabolic needs at that moment. Now you might say, well, perfusion pressure really isn't going to change that much, right? Why, blood pressure is fairly constant. However, the ventricle generates the blood pressure, and that pressure then falls the farther you move out through that cardiovascular circuit. Therefore, tissues that are closer to the heart would experience a higher perfusion pressure than tissues that are farther away. Does this mean they need more blood flow? Then do your hands need more blood flow than your feet? Not necessarily true. And so we need to accommodate this difference in distance from the heart by having this myogenic effect. Now, again, blood pressure can go up or down, and that we don't want that to affect our blood flow as well, right? We want to make sure that we're regulating blood flow to match metabolic need, not in response to changes in blood pressure. So if blood pressure were to rise, or perfusion pressure were to rise, or we were in a tissue that's closer to the heart, that would tend to make blood flow increase. We can see that in Poisson's law over here, right? Again, delta P drives our flow. And so if our perfusion pressure is higher, our flow would be higher. We don't necessarily need that. That would stimulate, that distension of the vessel would stimulate vasoconstriction. We can see that at our vessels up here, cross-section of our vessels getting smaller. As the radius of our vessels gets smaller, our resistance goes up dramatically, reducing our flow back to our autoregulated normal level. If perfusion pressure were to fall, or we were in a tissue that is farther from the heart, it would intrinsically tend to get lower flow. That's not necessarily what we need or want, and so we would get vasodilation in response. That would cause our vessels to get larger in diameter. That is reducing resistance to flow and bringing it back up to normal. Again, this myogenic effect is helping us match our perfusion pressure to the flow required through vasoconstriction or vasodilation caused by stretch or lack of stretch of those vessels in response to the driving pressure through them.